It's my pleasure and privilege to address you all today. I understand that the faculty, industry personnel, and students from more than 21 states are participating in this faculty development program. This shows that the present day faculty and students, along with the industry, are eager to learn about the recent trends and development in the engineering research. Engineering research seeks improvement in theory and practice. Engineering research is critical to an organization's productivity and competitiveness. It helps to fill gaps in knowledge and develop new products while improving the organizational efficiency and growth. Major contributors to engineering research around the world include governments, private businesses, industries, and academia. The academia and industry need to collaborate for taking the research to the next level and develop innovative solutions for the benefit of the society. Organizing FTP such as this reflects our effort in this direction. The development of the COVID-19 vaccine is a perfect example of how medical research has come to the rescue of mankind during the ongoing pandemic. Now, during this FTP, you will be learning about recent trends in healthcare, fuzzy logic control, as well as the use of video analysis, artificial intelligence, and machine learning for research. The technology of artificial intelligence deserves a special mention. This technology has invaded almost all fields of engineering and changed the way engineers are implementing solutions. Similarly, it has also changed the research process throughout the world. Although the research in artificial intelligence began way back in 1956, significant progress has happened only in the last decade, which has made the widespread use of this technology possible. Today, artificial intelligence is one of the fastest growing technologies among the basket of emerging technologies, and it enables machines to perform tasks that previously required human intelligence. Many of the tasks, such as design and simulation, can be enhanced with the support of artificial intelligence tools. Artificial intelligence programs can provide automation for low-value tasks, freeing up the engineer as well as the researcher to perform high-value tasks. By using machine learning to discover pattern in the data, these machines will become very important for analysis and decision-making in engineering. Now, for this FTP, we have some young and dynamic experts from the industry and the academia as resource persons. They have the requisite knowledge, experience, and the international exposure. I'm sure they will enlighten you all on the various aspects of the recent trends and opportunity in electronics and computer science. I wish all the participants a memorable 5-day experience of learning and assimilation of knowledge. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. We'll ensure that our participants will definitely get all the inputs that are required, as you have mentioned. I now request our principal, Dr. R.B. Lohani, to please address the gathering.
Hello. Good morning. Thank you, Mr. Chetan and Dr. Samad Burkar, the backbone of this event. At the outset, I would like to congratulate the department for continuing of the conduct of Atal FDP, the first department in Goa College of Engineering having FDP in a row, and thank AICT in showing faith in us by sanctioning this FDP. Dignitaries on the virtual platform, respected Dr. Vivek Kamath, a visionary, Director of Technical Education, Government of Goa, and Chief Patron of this FDP. I welcome you and thank you, sir, for your valuable time and support. Dr. Virani, Professor and Dynamic Proactive Head of Electronics and Telecommunication Department, the man behind the helm of affairs. And all my learned, respected participants from various parts of our beautiful nation, India. I am pleased that the Department of Electronics and Telecommunication is organizing the 5-day AICT Atal sponsored faculty development program on recent trends and opportunities for research in electronics and computer engineering from 24th May to 28th May. On a topic of vast interest to society, in particular to engineering and science faculties, and a step towards nation building to enhance its research footprint in the niche area, thereby enhancing organization productivity and competitiveness. A great work has been put within a very short period of time and seeing the pandemic situation. Thanks to the committed advisor, Dr. Virani, dynamic coordinator, Dr. Samar, and the entire organizing team, with a special thanks to Chetan Desai. I welcome and sincerely thank to all the learned resource persons who will make all the difference. The primary goal or purpose of research in any field of inquiry is to add to what is known about the phenomenon under investigation through application of scientific method. In this FDP, you will be enjoying the flavor of research in signal and image processing with an emphasis on medical imaging and also research related to fuzzy logic, robotics, and machine learning. I assure you, this FDP will bring a definite change to your outlook. Have 5-day real academic enjoyment without stress and technical fun. Take care, stay safe and healthy. Together, we will work to eradicate and win over COVID-19. Humbly request to follow all the WHO guidelines. Thank you very much and wish you a good day and good 5-day ahead. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. We will ensure that we communicate all the necessary guidelines to our participants. I'm sure as an online program, we already are making those people who are coming to their college and have to ensure the SOPs are followed. We will ensure that we will tell them so. Now, we would request our dynamic director, Dr. Vivek Kamath, tell us about his experiences with regards to this particular institute and the kind of role that he has played for us. I want to make this point over here that our director has been the main person behind our state's technical education. In terms of our engineering college, he has been a former principal, and for going ahead, he went on to become the director of the technical education of this state of Goa. We have had multiple initiatives started by sir, and each of those initiatives today have borne real fruits. Has been our own coordinator, Dr. Samarth Purkar, who has benefited immensely from the initiatives taken by our director. Our programs, each and every program, we make sure that we are in touch with sir, and we always get support. We just do not have any worries in terms of anytime, anything, last moment, if there is something that we need some kind of a guidance, we can always reach out to him, and he's always there to help us out. So how much significant Dr. Kamath has been to our growth in this, in terms of this institute, and I believe in the future also he will guide us and help us in taking this kind of. So without taking more time, sir, I request you to please kindly address the gathering.
Hello, a very good morning to you all. Thanks, Kedan, for nice words. Respected principal of Goa Engineering College, Professor Dr. R. B. Lohani, Head of Department, Electronics and Telecommunication, Professor Virani, the distinguished resource persons for this FDP, the delegates from, I believe, some 21 different states across the country, members of faculty of the college, ladies and gentlemen. It gives me great pleasure to be a part of this inaugural function of this FDP on recent trends and opportunities for research in electronics and computer science. Frankly speaking, I am not from the field of electronics or computer science, but the topic is apt not only for electronics and computer science, but it is also valid for various other branches of engineering. Now, when we talk of research, basically research leads to addition of some body of knowledge to the existing body of literature. It is some addition in terms of knowledge to the respective field of engineering or technology. I'm referring to the engineering research. This particular FDP is being conducted under the auspices of AICTE Training and Learning Academia, and the program for next 5 days is very well laid out. It starts with basics, that is how and why of research. Now, when we talk of how to identify the topic on which you would like to do your research, it starts with that, and then further how to go ahead and how to really conclude. Concluding your research work itself is an activity by itself, unless you are ably guided and motivated. Reaching that end and concluding the end at that particular stage is not that easy. Of course, all these activities have to be properly justified with the reason, the why aspect, why you are undertaking this particular research on this particular topic, or why you have identified this problem statement. And after finding various alternatives and the conclusion or the end results of your research, what difference it is going to make to the body of literature, that is what is expected from you. Now, the topics that will be discussed are covering a variety of topics. It starts from pattern recognition to image processing. It also touches aspects of artificial intelligence and machine learning. Even biomedical field applications will be covered. There's something to do with ophthalmology, that is some defects in the retina, how to detect the defects, all this using computer science. All this will be covered here. The focus looks to be on recent trends. And when you are apprised about the recent trends in these areas, which may be areas of your interest for research, you will know what research has happened over the years, what recent trend is in research as far as your field of research is concerned. And after being aware of these recent trends, you would end up in having two options. The first option, of course, would be to go along the trend. If you decide to go along the trend, you definitely have some advantages, because you are updated with the recent research work that has happened in that field. Various aspects of your problem identification and whatever basis that may be necessary for further thinking in those areas, that would be already established by your fellow researchers in the recent past. And in a way, you don't have to reinvent the wheel all over again. Of course, the disadvantage is also there. And the most important disadvantage is, as everywhere in the world, research is going on in this particular area, which is of interest to you also, it is possible that by the time you complete your research, somebody else has already found something very important and in fact more informative than what you are trying to do. And as a result, your efforts would go redundant in terms of research and innovation. Now, the other option, of course, is going along the untrodden ways. Now, untrodden means the areas which are not normally trodden by researchers. Areas untouched, virgin areas. Now, the disadvantage here is you don't have any back references. You don't have any established basis for progressing in your field. And most important advantage is the field is wide open for you for exploration. There are no competitors in this field. So the choice is yours, whether you want to go the untrodden way or you want to go along that trend. Now, once you identify which area you would like to go in for, I mean, of course, consulting with your peers or consulting with your guide or your teachers, you can then identify the problem statement. Now, for that, you'll have to go through the literature survey. And then, of course, it is followed by various experimentations or various alternatives will be evolved. And then finally, you have to select the best one and conclude. That concluding phase, again, is very important. Now, when we look at all these aspects of research, I am reminded of that very famous lyrics of in the film of late, I think it is late 70s or late 80s. I would say, research kiya nahi jata, ho jata hai. Of course, the converse is also true. Research ho nahi jata, kiya jata hai. And incidentally, both these statements are true in case of research. It will not happen on its own. You have to do it. And just putting in efforts is not sufficient. Something has to click also. So unless your research ho nahi jata, you are not done. Unless something clicks, you are not done. And what is that should click? For that, you have to definitely go all out, work tirelessly. And I'm sure through this 5-day session, the experts would guide you not only in the technological aspects of these areas, but also the methodology of how to go about your research work. And I'm sure at the end of this FDP, all the participants will benefit immensely from this, and they would definitely be able to go away with very valuable and very valid takeaways from this program. I thank the coordinator of this program, Professor Dr. Samarth Borkar, for inviting me for this program. And I also thank the principal and management of the college for giving me an opportunity to be part of this, another effort on part of GEC in its contribution towards the technological field. Wishing you all the very best. I take your leave. Thank you so much.
Thank you. You have really made us realize how much interesting research is with your anecdotes, with your comments. I'm sure all our participants will also realize how nice it is to do research. And we assure you, sir, that our faculty members who are going to be talking about the various aspects of research will try to inculcate among all the participants the same ideas that you have put out. And we hope that our participants will benefit immensely from the efforts that we put in. So thank you very much, sir. So I think we'll take a break for around 5 minutes, and we'll get back at 9:55. Okay, so thank you very much. We'll see you back at 9:55.